Well, what a gem this is. Would you believe this grainy film footage from the late 60s is of NFL Hall of Famer and Shreveport native Terry Bradshaw. Film reels that had to be saved from a dumpster. Louisiana Tech student employee named Carl Terrebonne tells me back in the late 80s, he was told to empty out a room in the athletic department and throw everything in the dumpster. He took home those reels and voila, he's discovered that. Well, tonight, we're not only interested in the good stuff delivered by Mr. Athlete, sports analyst, actor number 12, Terry Bradshaw, but the guy that was playing catch with him here in that video, Tommy Spinks. Catch they also played at Woodlawn High and in the Southern Hills and Shreveport neighborhood where their dream first began. Up this hill and down this sleepy dead-end road.
We had stories about him and his friends was throwing a ball out here somewhere.
Is where one of the most lively dreams ever tossed around was birthed back in the early 60s for two young teenagers.
We've been here about 5 years.
Robert Williams knows he now lives in the heart of famous Shreveport history.
It's Hill, Ohio, and Clintwood, Virginia.
He says weekly, letters by the dozen still show up at his Shady Lane home, not addressed to him.
I'm a Saints fan, believe me.
But to one of the most famous Pittsburgh Steelers to ever play the game.
Bradshaw.
Terry Bradshaw grew up in this home.
I was told that he used to throw it up here.
And first dreamed of playing in the NFL right here in this backyard. And while Bradshaw was dreaming, this other 13-year-old kid named Tommy Spinks was just pedaling through.
He was scoping out the neighborhood on his bike, and he saw this real tall, blonde-headed kid in his backyard.
It's when Tommy, just weeks after his family pulled up roots and moved to Shreveport's Southern Hills, first caught glimpse of Terry and his football dream.
And he stalked him for days, just watching him. He's always by himself throwing the ball. And then it was finally, Terry ran out in the front yard and sees my dad, sticks out his hand and says, "Hi. My name is Terry Bradshaw. You want to throw some?" And that was the very beginning of a friendship that would last the rest of their lives.
Kimberly Spinks Burleson.
They brought out the best in each other.
They did.
And Terry Spinks Netterville know that's exactly how their late father, Tommy Spinks, first met his lifelong friend, Terry Bradshaw.
We found the folder full of the stories, and this is how he wrote them.
Because of this amazing discovery. Pages and pages of notes and stories written by their father.
You pick up the phone and call Terry and go, "Terry."
Yes. You're not even going to believe this.
Yes.
Found tucked away in a closet 2 years after their father passed away at only 58 years old.
We dove into the stories. We were rolling. And then we'd start crying.
Already forced to accept losing their father at such a young age, just months after being diagnosed with cancer.
Reading those stories, we grew to know why Dad was the way he was.
They quickly realized what they were now holding. Their father, Mr. Woodlawn High, an All-American at Louisiana Tech who played in the NFL, all things just like his best friend Terry, had been writing a book.
And I never thought about what made him so great until after we found these stories.
So they pulled together their dad's decades of stories for what they initially thought would be for a limited audience.
This whole book was supposed to be a Christmas gift for our children to know our dad better. And through the process, we got to know our dad better.
Stories about growing up in a brand new city and making new friends, including that impromptu first game of catch in Southern Hills, which led to decades more through high school and college.
He and Terry and all these different people that were influencers and they were earth angels and they were hilarious. Some of the stories are so gross that we didn't even put them in the book because he and Terry were as goofy.
In that time, Terry tried to play relationship counselor when Tommy and his eventual wife, Barbara, got into that argument in high school.
Terry, he's always butting into their fights, and he typed out this letter. "Barbara loves Tommy Spinks because she told me so. They'll make up. And they really love each other. I don't want them to fight. Your forever friend, Terry Bradshaw, number 12.
And stories involving his ever-growing circle of Woodlawn High School friends.
Tommy was one of those type of friends and friendships that we had that whenever we reconnected, it was just like we'd never missed a beat.
Friends like family law judge Bobby Waddell.
I miss picking up the phone and saying, "Hey, what are you doing?" We talked once a week or so.
And Cecil Marr, who landed on page 258. His early years as a promising young preacher in training.
Tommy and Terry had invited me to come to their church to speak. on a Sunday evening.
They were sitting in the back of the pew. Terry had his Sports Illustrated between his Bible.
The night that I spoke was the night that Neil Armstrong walked on the moon. A lady came by and said, "Now, son, don't keep us too long. We got to watch him walk on the moon tonight."
Even competing against Neil Armstrong didn't faze this up-and-coming preacher.
This fire came out of him. He was like a Billy Graham, just, and they were in shock.
The sister's book, titled Dreamcatcher, is fitting on so many levels.
The best stuff.
That's the best stuff.
That is good stuff.
For one, Tommy grew up playing baseball.
He could have played baseball, and he would have been a stud at baseball, too.
But on that day in Terry's backyard, Bradshaw called it audible, telling Tommy, "Well, I don't even think we even have baseball here. And if we do, nobody plays it. Football is king in Shreveport." Just minutes after meeting this guy named Terry, Tommy's dream was now crossing the 20 and headed straight for the end zone, and no longer rounding third and headed for home.
I asked my dad 6 days before he died, "Dad, did you always dream of playing in the NFL? He said, "No." He said, "That was Terry's dream. I caught it. Dreams are contagious."
Terry's dream had become their dream.
In that one statement, "Dreams are contagious," he caught Terry's dream. It was not his dream to begin with.
Not because Terry demanded it, but because of a friendship that simply revealed it.
The dynamics between the two of them was so real and so raw.
And now it's Tommy's grandchildren who have spent years catching his dream. No, they're not all destined for the NFL, but whether it's a basketball or a volleyball court, the football field, or the baseball diamond, Tommy's high school jersey number 11 is still making the rounds, including on the back of former Bird High School standout Steele Netterville through the years,
hit toward left center field, back on it goes Dennis, still going back,
who's now playing sports at Tech, just like his granddaddy.
Steele Netterville!
Most of Tommy's 14 grandchildren weren't even born when he passed. That number 11 on their backs helps keep his memory close.
"Terry, if you're reading this message, it means I lost my battle with cancer, but I consider myself the lucky one. Hold on."
And on that day, 6 days before he died,
"Come on, Terry."
A very ill Tommy dictated this letter to his daughters, written to his forever friend, Terry Bradshaw.
"I am thankful for you. I just love being your best friend. Your dreams became my dreams, and what a blast we had working to make them come true. I don't know why things turned out the way they did for me, but I don't have any regrets."
For Terry and Kimberly, it's like hearing him have one of his last conversations with them all over again.
"I love you, Bradshaw. My memories with you are full of so much stinking fun and laughter. Thanks for the memories. Take care of yourself until we meet again, Tommy."
That letter closes out over 300 pages of stories, writings, and memories told by the man himself.
That's love.
Tommy Spinks.
"To me, it was like the exclamation mark at the end of a life well lived. That one letter said it all to me."
"We have a lot of things in there that he had left."
But you knew this story wouldn't be complete without one more pass from Bradshaw. A passage, actually, we found written not in the pages of Tommy's book.
Right there. If you could zoom in on it.
But inside the old Bradshaw work shed on Shady Lane.
"The most beautiful things in the world are not seen
or touched. They are felt with the heart. You thought Terry only knew how to throw touchdown passes with that right hand."
"And that's what life is about. It's about love, friendship, and making memories and leaving a legacy to those that you love."
And as you might have guessed, Tommy's daughter, Terry, is named after Terry Bradshaw. And Kimberly tells me Bradshaw used to babysit her. Not many people can tell that story to their friends through the years. The book right here, Dreamcatcher, it's far beyond just a desire by family members, is available on Amazon, dreamcatcherbook.com. And oh, by the way, those Bradshaw fan club letters, it's amazing that many still show up at that address. Robert tells me he periodically gives those letters to a Bradshaw family friend who still lives just down the street on Shady Lane.
My goodness, what a great story.